At base camp, honestly, 48 hours ago, I never thought I'd be here. It's definitely been a hard but definitely rewarding trip up here. So tomorrow morning, obviously the biggest attempt is getting to the summit of Rinjani. So no promises, but definitely give it my best shot. See how we go.
Today was probably the hardest day. Sound like a broken record. It was unbelievable. I met a whole lot of imaginary friends in my mind as I was climbing up that trail, and thanks to Pete and Farmy, we got up, and I've had a good massage and a stretch from Craigie. Thanks, Craig. And we've just had a nice bite to eat. Behind me, as you can see, the most magnificent sunset you could ever imagine. You can see the volcanoes of Bali out in the distance, and the cloud bank has just come up and settled just below the ridges. It is truly spectacular. The camera can't do it justice. Left and to my right is the most beautiful profile of the ridges and the trees. It's truly poetic in its splendour. Getting up 2:30 tomorrow morning. Looking forward to that, obviously. So I'll probably have a bit better sleep than I did last night. I slept on a tree root where the others were sleeping on banks of ferny grass and moss, so that's my excuse anyway. So you'll see us at 2:30 tomorrow morning. Until then, Mal Walden, National 9 News.
Enjoying a nice little homemade Indonesian cigarette. Not the ideal preparation, but looking forward to the challenge in the morning, and should be great to get there.
We'll just see how tomorrow goes, and you'll hear from me tomorrow at the summit.
Two thoughts are going through my mind, and that there can be no triumph without a struggle. And tomorrow morning, 2 a.m., 3 a.m., 3 hours walk, 3 hours struggle. Hopefully be at the top for the triumph.
I'm looking forward to the view when I finally get to the top tomorrow. I've had a great time here so far. It's a fantastic place, and I can't wait to summit the mountain. Should be great.
It's 3 o'clock in the morning at base camp, and we're all having a cup of tea and readying ourselves for the climb. It's about a 3 hour climb to the summit. The sun should be up about 6:30, so it's one thing to get to the summit, but it's another thing to get there by sunrise. So the chase is on to get to the top before the sun pops its head above the horizon. Let's see how we go.
It's me again. It's 3 a.m. and I'm the first one to pull out. I just got no energy left. Just the past 3 days have been pretty hard. And I'm just not going up because I don't want to put the other guys down. I don't want to be the straggler, so to speak. Got another gut ache. I feel like I'm going to throw up again. But just hopefully the other guys get up. I do feel ashamed for not going, but I just don't think I could do it.
Start of the ridge, we've done the first part of the summit climb. The moonlight's allowing us to look down on the most magnificent sight. It's hard work, but everyone's doing pretty well, and we're gonna make it. See you at the top.
Okay, we've come up the second ridge line. We're basically at the base of the ridge line that takes us to the summit, which is the most difficult and demanding of all the ridges. Everyone's doing well. We think Gerard's pulled out, we're not sure yet. It's a bit hard to tell, everyone's sort of spread out. We've been very fortunate, had a bit of rain and the footings are either a little bit more solid or you can see where the person before you stood, so you can step in their steps. But onwards to the summit, probably another 45 minutes to an hour for the sunset.
I'm tired, but I'm here. You may get my sunrise, but hey, it's only a minor detail.
I'm rooted. Sorry, Mum.
We made it.
Last night I said that no triumph could be achieved without a struggle, and boy was it a struggle, but all the boys got up here, they did it well, and the views are fantastic, and just looking forward to getting down out of this cold actually.
Well, I've gone face down about 8 times walking up that scoria. Unbelievable. Pumice sized stones the size of your fist. You take one step up, you go 2 steps back. It was like sort of Dante's Inferno down there. It was just unbelievable. Thank you to the fit boys. They didn't pick on the fat kid this time when I got up, but that was just unbelievable. Words can't describe it. I think best left to the pictures.